Hi guys, when I was driving home today, I saw a man at the crosswalk working on training with his doggo, and he had a prong collar on his dog. Awesome.
Yeah, guys, prong collars are no big deal. You know what? And personally, I don't care what you use. I do not care what tool you use. But this is what I do care about. Somebody that's been struggling for years, I want you to find answers. I want you to find the correct answers. You can use any tool you want. It doesn't matter. But if you're struggling with your dog, but you're closed off to a solution because of some supposed higher ground, your dog pays the ultimate price, and so do you, because your world gets really, really small. We have so many people who have said, I feel like a prisoner of my own home. So for all the folks out there that are anti-tool, let me tell you about a lot of our clients. They can't go out on date night. Now, you might take that for granted, or maybe you don't get dates, but they want to go out with their spouse, with their lover. They want to jump on a Tinder and be able to say, yeah, I'll be ready in 2 hours. But I've got clients who have a dog and have not been on a date with their spouse for years, years. Like, they can't run to Panera Bread together for 45 minutes. By the way, those new Baja bowls at Panera Bread with the autumn squash soup, fucking killer. Okay, so years, they can't do that. So you might think you don't need these tools, but guess what? Someone else does, and it's not because they're lazy or anything else. It's because they're struggling. Their dog is not your dog. You have not walked in their footsteps. Next.
Going live.
Now we're live. We got comments and everything. Yeah, we're live. Now we're live. Hey, everybody, how are you? Where are we? What part of West Virginia are we in? We're in West Virginia.
Waterfall or something?
We just pulled into West Virginia. We're at Julie and Josh's house from Julie's Canine Academy. Josh, no, I don't know why Josh's name isn't in the fucking the title, but you know, he might want to talk to Julie about that.
It should be JJ.
So something. Okay. So we're over here for our Q&A of the night. We made it to 9 o'clock because we just had to stop and go shopping for food, and you know, we drove. We didn't know what time we'd land here, so here we are. Anyway, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is Joelle.
Hello.
We're not using those.
So
what we're gonna do is this. It's a Q&A show. I do a Q&A show 3 nights a week, historically Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for an hour and a half. Then I do a two-day seminar series. In fact, this weekend we'll be in North Carolina. That's where we're heading now. We just came from Fargo, North Dakota. By the way, we just announced New Zealand, Auckland, New Zealand. We're doing an Auckland, New Zealand, Brisbane, Australia, and Singapore tour, as well as 25 other locations in 2020 in North America. So Canada and the US. All the locations haven't been announced yet because we're still looking for venues to do it in. Now, most of those people bring dogs with really bad behaviors and they want us to stop them. So the two-day seminars, how do I stop this, like name the behavior. By the way, it's really weird, funny. Sometimes I see other people's seminars and they've got like restrictions on like who they can bring, like no shutdown dogs, only bring high drive dogs, food drive. It's like fearful dog, like you bring any dog you want to. Your dog can try to bite my face off. I don't care, you're welcome, come on in. All the dogs are in a room together and they all stop barking and I can have a conversation.
Crated.
So crated, of course. But eventually they all come out of the crate and they're all doing downstays next to each other. And then I do this three days a week podcast. Sorry guys, I'm exhausted. And then the training center. Now the training center, we do it all. In fact, if you want to see how we work at the training center, watch some of our how-to videos on actually how we train dogs. It's actually a pretty long process. So in my how-to videos, we don't say the word no and apply a punisher until the dog has done something 300 to 400 times. But on my podcast, I'm going to teach you how to properly punish. And at the seminars, I teach you how to properly punish instantly. Because you're here to stop an unwanted behavior. Leash reactivity, barking, separation anxiety, leash pulling, redirection, human aggression, dog aggression. My answers are quick, They're snarky. Most people here need actually like a 5-week board and train to your question, or at a minimum of a Skype. There is something at the bottom of your screen. It's a dollar sign. A lot of people, what they want to do is it'll get your question to the top of the queue, but you do not need to pay to play. We will answer every question. At least we try to. It's a fast-paced show. Some people are just like, thanks for just the years of free content. Joelle is, she is leads now a 4-person social media team. And all that team is giving away free stuff. Literally, she's building a team to give away more free information, make more free videos, make more free posts. How can we help more people for free with no obligation of anything else in return, which I encourage all of you to do, is to give. Okay, Joelle asks the questions, I give the answers. Let's go.
Top chat, $10 from Jamie.
Hey Jamie, thank you so much.
Changed my ways, structured walk training 2 times a day, 1 hour back and forth on my dirt road with the prong.
Awesome.
He stays at heel, sits down at stop, but still on hair trigger with animal distractions. Tips, love you.
Yeah. Truly, your freaking internet here sucks. Stream quality's been automatically lowered.
Oh, wow. We're out in the middle of
Aren't you on Fios? What are you, dial-up, AOL out here? So anyway,
Don't shame her.
I'm not shaming her. Thanks for the free Wi-Fi, by the way.
Yeah, thanks for letting us into your home and letting us stay on your property and for giving us bottled water.
Thank you so much. Hair trigger, what I want you to do is, when I talk about punishment, the biggest thing with the punishment shirt is this. The first sign of the bad behavior, that's when you apply your correction. Don't apply it afterwards. You missed it. It's too late. Think about, okay, we talk about rehab a lot, alcohol and drug. If you're struggling with an alcohol problem, you're trying to stay sober, you're not allowed in the bar. Not until you are like really got good impulse control. No, you can't go to the bar. No, you can't have one drink. You're an alcoholic. You can have no drinks. You can't go to the bar. You might not even be able to be around alcohol. Eventually, you can be around alcohol, but you probably can never have one drink. So with your dog, you know your dog's leash reactive, you know your dog's on a hair trigger, at the first sign of like, that hard and heavy, overwhelming punishment. Punishment, by the way, you don't yell, you don't scream, you're not mad, you're not angry. It's just, don't do that. That's why we love our tools. Remote collars, bonkers. Did a great post on bonking, a little meme on bonking the other day. I want everyone that's on the fence about bonking to read the comments below from actual users, people that use this. Okay, next.
Britt, hi, my German Shepherd does not bark at dogs when they're on leash or grates, but when a dog is off leash in the front, she does. Do you consider that aggression?
No, it's not aggression at all. It's just nuisance barking. So just tell your dog to shut up. Next. Guys, aggression? Okay, we specialize in aggression. We're very, very, very selective on when we use that word. Aggression is intent to harm. Not looking like it's going to harm. It is actually intending to harm. Meaning, like, you don't know your dog's aggressive until it gets into a dog fight. So please don't find out. But being at the end of a leash and looking like it's going to be aggressive is not aggressive. Now, you might have an aggressive dog that also does that. But until your dog has attacked another dog or bitten a human, you can't use the word aggression. You can only use the word bad behavior or reactivity at this point. Next.
Teresa, good evening, Joelle and Jeff. Hey, Teresa.
Hey, Teresa, how are you?
Melissa, evening all.
Hey, Melissa, thanks for being here at this late hour.
Tommy, hey, J&J.
Hey, Tommy, what's going on, buddy?
Michelle, good evening, Jeff, Joelle, and Melissa. Hope your travels are going well. Stay safe.
Travels are going fantastic. We've been running, for all my fellow RVers out there, I'm sure you can appreciate this. We actually ran the generator while we were driving. Because the back end couldn't warm down enough, and we've got, by the way, cool down. We're traveling with five dogs on this trip. It's the first time that Joelle has brought her dogs, and we'll probably end up talking more about that. So we're traveling with 5 dogs and 1 dog in heat, and guess what? It's pretty simple.
Pretty simple.
Next.
Bronwyn, good evening, Jeff, Joelle, and Melissa.
Hey.
And Josh, haha, hope you're all doing well.
How about Julie? Julie's with the hostess with the mostest. Next.
Alicia, hey, you gotta get my questions in now. I'll have to watch the replay.
Okay, awesome.
Britt, my shepherd walked past 4 nippy dogs while walking past and no reaction.
Wow.
And nice. Most of the time she hears dogs bark and just walks not barking. It's great bragging though.
So proud of you. And just guess what? You're doing the hard work. For all of you out there that are doing all the hard work, kudos to you. Okay? I have the information, but you're doing the work. So kudos to you. Next.
Phantom Canine Training. Hey, it's David. Just picked up another dog from the shelter. They couldn't praise Jeff enough. Great shelter. Much love and respect.
Awesome. Mad respect to them. Tell them I said hi.
Dar, love the J&J tips. First time in a while listening live. Yippee. Keep up all your content.
Hey, great. Hey, Dar, we'll be back in Elkhart soon. Love
we haven't
you,
done
buddy.
A tip in a little bit. We're slacking. We got stuff to do.
But we're not slacking. How much?
I know.
You have so many videos on your phone that we just don't have time.
I know.
Even with your team.
I know.
It's we can't put it out and we can't overwhelm the feed, but we're going to have to start. But we're going to be on TikTok soon and we're going to be upping our LinkedIn game. So yeah. Next.
Alicia, I understand how to bonk and stop nonsense in the crate with my puppy, but how do you stop the nonsense and excitement when they come out? He's too excited, jumping, vocal, sometimes nipping and tinkling.
Okay, put the dog on a leash. All untrained dogs should be on leashes. All dogs that are not underneath voice control should be on a leash, but you can bonk the dog out of the crate as well. Next.
Shona, feels so silly, but I cannot get this 9-week-old Vishla to down. The butt always pops up. Help, I'm on a mission. Pushing the back down, even though she's tiny, isn't working. She resists so hard.
First of all, it's 9 weeks old. Cool your jets. Second of all, sit on the floor. It's we all done with food, by the way. Everything we do with food. You sit on the floor, put your legs up like you were like, so your back is straight, your legs are up like you're resting a book against yourself, but then lower your legs, take food, put it in between your legs, and then have the dog crawl underneath your leg to get the food, and then slowly push your leg down, okay? Next.
Yuko, wow, you are just awesome. I've been working to teach my dog what no means. Sometimes little pop correction, another time ugly correction. I know why it's so important to say no before the correction.
Yeah, anybody that doesn't believe in the word no, or you can use any word, but a correction word, a marker, by the way, no. And then a consequence after that, like, what's your dog doing? And for all the people out there that are like, oh, I don't believe in correcting my dog. I only believe in positive. It's like, first of all, let's see what your dog can do in the real world, not a series of tricks. Nothing against trick training. We actually have a trick training class, okay? I actually have a trick training video out called Cool Dog Tricks. Brittany actually made it. It's all done without punishment, by the way, but in real world, in real life. So it's important. All dogs need to learn what no is. And if there's anybody out there thinking that they don't need to, you're living in a fantasy world. You just are. Next.
Jasmine, what can I do about whining? My 8-month-old puppy whines about everything, literally everything. It's driving me crazy.
Remote collar to stop whining. There's an art to it though, but also bonker. Next.
Rose Brothers Dog Training. After watching your videos on the bonkers, I mentioned them on just one of my tons of Ask the Trainer videos. Today I had someone ask me about them after watching my videos. I sent them to yours.
Awesome. Make your own too. Congratulations. Next.
Yuko, my dog used to lunge or chase runner bicycle, but wow, I told him no. As soon as he looks there, he was like, oh shit, and he had back to heel position checking on me.
Yep, it
does. Training pays off.
Sorry.
Thank you.
Of course it does. We had a bicycle lunger at the Fargo seminar, and we stopped it in front of everybody instantly.
Yeah, I'm gonna edit that video.
Instantly. And by the way, I wasn't handling the dog. The owner was. See, that's another thing, guys. For all my colleagues out there, for my colleagues, make sure your owners are getting 90% of the leash time. And for all my owners out there, make sure you can do it as well. Us dog trainers, we can do it. The art of what we do is training you. If you can't do it, it doesn't make a difference how good we are. So there's something called value posts and vanity posts. We absolutely put up vanity posts to show what we're doing at the dog training center. But there's also something called value posts. Value posts mean more to me. So, you know, Joelle is really good. Brittany is really good. My staff at the training center is really good. And keep complimenting them. Thank you so much. But I can speak for myself. I can only speak for myself. I like it more when owners tell me they watched one of my free videos and they got great results. That means more to me than anything in the world. Next.
Keaton. Hey y'all, my young Malinois has started to find her voice. So much fur calm, Malinois. Haha.
Yep. You can fix that. I've got a Malinois too. Next.
Rose Brothers Dog Training. They also came from my free seminar from last week. Thanks for all the info and the messages. Your favorite critic turned student.
Awesome. Proud of you. Next.
Andrew, for fearful dogs that don't budge when going on a walk, just standing still with tail tucked, I know you said to use a prong and say, let's go, and start walking. Should we drag them until they move?
No, well, first of all, it doesn't make a difference what word you use. And no, do not drag them. First thing you do is you try north, south, east, west. So imagine you're heading north. It doesn't have to be north, but imagine you're heading north. Okay, Jack? Your name's not Jack. That's an inside joke to my host in Fargo. And then they don't move. Go south. See if they move. They don't move. Go east. See if they move. They don't move. Go west. Hey, they start walking west. Boom. Loop around and start going north. You can also use a remote collar to motivate them. So this is the thing. A lot of people say, oh, they're nervous. They're fearful. They're tired. Really? Take off the leash. Don't do this. Take off the leash. Unclip the leash. Guess what they do? They run around. They're none of the above. What is called is an objection. It's a kid in a candy store screaming in the aisle because it couldn't get candy. The dog just says, I don't want to walk anymore. Now, obviously, if it's a bulldog and it's 110 out, it's a different story. But what we're talking about is what we see all the time is your typical objection of a dog just planting itself on the ground. Next.
Britt, do you think shepherds tend to get protective at night over their owners on walks? I see that sometimes.
Yes, I think at nighttime, dogs absolutely get a little bit more protective. Next.
Julie, hi guys. When I was driving home today, I saw a man at the crosswalk working on training with his doggo, and he had a prong collar on his dog. Awesome.
Yeah, guys, prong collars are no big deal. You know what? And personally, I don't care what you use. I do not care what tool you use. But this is what I do care about. Somebody that's been struggling for years, I want you to find answers. I want you to find the correct answers. You can use any tool you want. It doesn't matter. But if you're struggling with your dog, but you're closed off to a solution because of some supposed higher ground, your dog pays the ultimate price, and so do you, because your world gets really, really small. We have so many people who have said, I feel like a prisoner of my own home. So for all the folks out there that are anti-tool, let me tell you about a lot of our clients. They can't go out on date night. Now, you might take that for granted, or maybe you don't get dates, but they want to go out with their spouse, with their lover. They want to jump on a Tinder and be able to say, yeah, I'll be ready in 2 hours. But I've got clients who have a dog and have not been on a date with their spouse for years, years. Like, they can't run to Panera Bread together for 45 minutes. By the way, those new Baja bowls at Panera Bread with the autumn squash soup, fucking killer. Okay, so years, they can't do that. So you might think you don't need these tools, but guess what? Someone else does, and it's not because they're lazy or anything else. It's because they're struggling. Their dog is not your dog. You have not walked in their footsteps. Next.
Kiki. Deanna just started walking 14-week-old pup on prong. Pup is easily spooked, tries to walk ahead. What kind of correction is appropriate for a pup this age?
I would actually, you're going through some fear period right there. I would just stay I would get that dog as much exposure as possible, but I would take it really, really slow. I wouldn't be correcting 14-week-old puppy on a prong collar for, you know, much. I would be just focusing on maybe the heel. Next.
Janine donated $1.99.
Oh, thank you. Question, though. Thank you, Janine. Thank you.
Kara, just got done with my second pack walk and barely any whining. Trainer said nice. He wants to get me working with dogs too. I think I got the job. He called me a show off. Haha.
Cool. Awesome.
Oh, that was the last show where she said her dog started to react or something.
Nice. Proud of you.
So that's good. Perry. Should you always throw the bonker at the dog, or is holding it and bonking the dog just as effective?
Yeah, you tell me. This is what is important, though, guys, for bonkers and any punisher out there historically. There's some punishers we don't give a marker for. So for fence fighting, we don't give markers. For eating poop, we don't give markers. You have to say no first. Just like you have to say yes or good or click before you give the food reward. By the way, guys, we clicker train all the dogs on our property.
Sure do.
We use food on every single dog on our property. So if they have food drive. So you have to say no, then you apply the punisher. If you want to say no and then throw, that's fine. If you want to say no and then just, you know, bop the dog on the nose, that's fine. If your dog goes, when I throw the bonker, my dog plays with it, you didn't do it hard enough. I've worked with some serious high drive dogs. The last thing they wanted to do was play with that bonker. Next.
Perry, should you always, I already read that. Jane, dropped our 9-month mini for a 3-week board and train at solid canine training on Monday. Saw one post of her on Instagram, hoping for more confidence and proficiency with her obedience.
Yeah, well, it takes time. So dropped her off on Monday. What's today?
Wednesday.
So today's Wednesday. Okay. So, I mean, you've got time. You've got time. So don't worry about it. But remember, what I want you to do while your dog is with us is you need to change too. So what we want to make sure is we tell this to every client. Don't think you're just going to send the dog to us. It's going to come back and then you can revert back to your old ways, or so will the dog. So you also need to change. How do you do that? Read the book. You should have already been reading the book that we already gave you. Watch our content. Be ready to do a 90-day boot camp at your home. And be ready to do things that are difficult for you, possibly here. But that's how we make change. If it was easy, every dog would do great. But it's not easy, it's hard. Here's a great example. I got 2 hours, we slept about the same amount of time. You know, we got about, 3-4 hours of sleep last night. Yeah. We were both at the gym this morning, exhausted, okay? We both ate healthy today. So we actually, while we travel, we're on this one for 8 days. 8 days, we should go to the gym 7 times. Mm-hmm. We might miss one day, mm-hmm. We might. Just because of logistics.
Yeah.
But Julie, can we borrow your car to go to the gym tomorrow morning, by the way?
Yeah.
Thanks. So we're definitely going to Planet Fitness tomorrow. Last night we parked in the Planet Fitness parking lot. If you watch us on IG stories, you'll know that. We just came from the grocery store right before we got here. We bought a bunch of our food consisting of fruits, vegetables, salads, and lean meats. And if we go out, we'll eat something healthy. And if so, a lot of people say, oh, it's so hard to keep to your, you know, your routine on the road. No, it's not. It's called lack of discipline. You don't have there's not an option issue. It's a lack of discipline issue. Next.
$4.99 top chat from James. J&J, you've given me a great relationship with my dog with your free help. Thank
awesome.
You. E-collar boost is set at 25 and works, but he yelps. Is this too high?
Well, first of all, I would get off boost. Mm-hmm. And even though my old videos show that, do manual. This is the thing. The question isn't, is it too high? The question is, did it stop the bad behavior? Okay? That's the question. So we have a fan in the RV and it fell down today and one of the dogs yelped. The dog was 8 feet away from it. It startled it. It didn't hurt the dog. Dogs yelp for lots of different reasons. But I also don't know the behavior of your dog. So say you've got a leash reactive dog or a dog aggressive dog or a dog that used to pull you down the street and all of a sudden it started to look at another dog and you know where that's going and you hit boost or you hit the shock collar and the dog let out an audible. We call it an audible, which is what it is. There's a couple of reasons why the audible might have come out. It startled the dog, or yes, there was discomfort. Now, I'm not going to be one of these people that says you shouldn't have to use pain to train. That's the biggest line of bullshit in the world. You don't work with dogs like we work with. And your dog's already in pain, but so are you. Most injuries happen from pulling dogs, not biting dogs. The frequency as well as the cost of repair from someone being pulled and knocked down. So, was it too high? Maybe. But did it stop the behavior? Next.
Alicia, is it true that if you continually pick up or carry and engage in the jumpy behavior of a puppy, they will also be jumpy as an adult because you never corrected? I keep saying things, but not getting compliance from you know who, laughing my ass off.
So you tell me, the more you do something, the more you get. It's called training. Got it? So you are training a dog to lick your face. So your puppy is cute now, but if it's going to be 30 pounds, 50 pounds, 80 pounds, don't be surprised when it jumps on you and tries to lick your face. Next.
True. Julie, so from the back of my house and my dog barks out the front window, what is the most effective way to correct that action for my dog, seeing as I miss the arousal?
So you mark it with no, and then you can go and correct your dog afterwards. But I would use a shock collar. I call them shock collars. You can call them remote collars. You can call them remote trainers. You can call them whatever you want to. It doesn't really make a difference. No, correct. Guess what? The dog stops barking. Next.
Marvelous Maker. It is kind of funny. I thought I was failing at dog training until I took the dog to the vet. The vet commented, "You have such a well-behaved dog."
Yep. You know, this is it. So kudos to you. The bar, this is what's really sad in the United States. It doesn't take much to have a well-behaved dog. The bar is so freaking low in our country. It's so low. Like, every dog should be able to go to a coffee shop, do a downstay for an hour while you have a cup of coffee. Even the most aggressive dogs, put a muzzle on them, put them in a down. You know, that's what we want. We want public access training for everybody. Everybody should have a minimum of the public access training that a service dog has. Next.
$24.99 Top Chat from Shona. Hey, J&J, first time on this live forum. Love your channel and all the content. I've been hooked since I found you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Shona. Next.
Jillian, crate whining in four-month-old puppy, two-year-old dog, and pup's crate are right next to each other. I've used the e-collar when not in the room and sock bonking when in the room. Still whining. Continue.
Yeah, well, you might be doing it wrong, so I'm not quite sure. I'm not there. But you might have to take the dog, you know, the last thing I want anybody to do is just push a button. There's an art to stopping whining with a remote collar. Bonking, the dog might have to come out of the crate to bonk. Next.
Jane, where do you post pictures from the seminars? I was at the Providence seminar and don't think I got an email with a link.
Emails did go out. Look in your spam file, but you don't need to do that. On my Facebook page, if you're on your laptop or a desktop, the left-hand side, it says home, about, It says photos. Click on photos, all of a sudden it goes into my albums. There is a Providence album. Click on that, you'll see all the photos. There's close to 300 of them. Next.
Julie says, by the way, love you guys.
Love you too, Julie.
Jillian, no playing in the house, only play outside unless on place in the crate when in the house.
That's my rules, but I don't expect everybody to have my lifestyle. I find a dog walking around a home sort of senseless when they should be out, they can be outside running around and then come in the home and practice them relaxing. So, you know, I'm gonna turn the camera around for everybody. By the way, thank you for Spotify, SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, all the Google platforms. Thank you so much for listening and watching. So right there, do you see that dog? That's Riggins. He's in place. Look at this floor. They just moved in, they don't have a couch yet. There's the baby. No, the baby's in his pack and play right there. But there's Riggins. But the baby can be a couple of feet away from Riggins. In fact, tomorrow, if you look at by the way, if you have not joined Angelo Gellman on Instagram yet, please join Angelo Gellman. Tomorrow, I am posting the first interaction that Angelo had with my dogs.
Oh, you found it?
I found it. He's 72 hours old. It's the day he came home from the hospital.
Nice.
Yep, I'm posting it tomorrow. Next.
Harry Bear, good morning, guys. Hope you're both well. Love, Harry from the UK.
How are you feeling? You're still feeling sick?
I'm definitely like congested.
Yeah, so I noticed. I think it was the AC because we have to run the AC. We ran our generator all through the night last night. My RVers can appreciate that. Tonight we have to run the generator because we're staying at someone's house, and generators don't run off of your typical household current. It blows the circuit, so we have to run the generator. Next.
Jasmine, when my dog is in my backyard, he is constantly scanning, looking for something to freak out at, and I notice he's doing this on walks too. Is there something I can do about this?
Yeah, you correct it. I would use a remote collar to correct it. Next.
Bronwyn, got my aunt set up with two bonkers for her two tiny barking machines.
Awesome.
She is so happy to have them finally be quiet when people and dogs pass in front of the house.
Yes.
Bonkers are like hot. ticket today.
Bonkers are one of the best punishers in the world. Here's a really badly made
horrible.
One.
Horrible. What is this?
This is a horrible one right here. Okay. Okay. No matter how much no matter how much Joelle touches that, it's not gonna get hard. So, you know, but I'm gonna have to teach them obviously, you know, how to make bonkers.
These are not 64 rubber bands.
Okay. But you know, what I'm gonna do is if you go to my website, my YouTube channel.
Do these work?
I'm sure they do work, okay? Even a limp dick works, okay? So she got pregnant. Okay, next.
In what world, Alicia? If sudden movements hype your dog up, how can you calm them down and let them know it's not playtime and stop the arousal?
So number one, you bonk to stop the arousal. Number two, you put them in place in a down and you start dummy-proofing them. In other words, it looks like teasing, but it's not teasing. So you put your dog into a down and you start making sudden movements. So if you're fortunate like I am, who I'm Jewish, we talk with our hands a lot. For all my Italian friends, okay, they can use our hands. For my Irish fans, be careful, you're gonna spill your fucking whiskey. So what you can do is you can do all stuff like this, okay? And then if your dog breaks command, correct. Next.
Shona. Hey, J&J, so thankful I found you. I've learned a lot from your videos since last week.
Awesome. Yeah, well, you got a couple thousand more to go. So proud of you. Next.
Johnny, hello guys. Question, my dog misbehaves in the house, so I correct him, and sometimes he pees when I do correct him. He's a 2-year-old heeler.
Okay, so the breed doesn't matter. I don't know how you're correcting him. So it should be a neutral no and then correct. I don't know what you're using as a correction. So I've seen a lot of people use, like, they're yelling at their dogs or they're rushing their dogs. They're trying to look big and intimidating and they're trying to scare their dog. I'm thinking again, scaring your dog, but to me, I just like to say no and push a button on most punishers. Next.
Christine asked Josh to sing and play his guitar. He's good. Did it on a video a couple weeks ago. Landslide, I think.
So what you can do is this. You can go over to Julie's channel and you can make that request. Next.
Jillian, been seeing your out videos. Same as leave it and drop it?
Yeah, this is just a word. Guys, I speak English. Out is an English word. It means drop whatever is in your mouth, but also move away from something. The word doesn't matter. You can, because in non-English speaking countries, they use other words. Next.
Rebecca, good day, guys. My question is, when do the tools become less prominent? Is the intent of the training for the long game? I know you still use tools ongoing. Does my shepherd need a prong for life?
So first of all, would you ask that if it was a martingale? A martingale is a training tool. So you can do whatever you want to do. But the way I look at it is this. A leash, if your dog is on a leash, it has to be hooked up to something. Correct? It has to be hooked up to some sort of collar. Something around the dog's neck. In most places by law. Flat buckle collar, martingale, some people use harnesses, some people use head halters. All of those are fine if you want to. We don't. We use prong collars. If it has to be hooked up to a collar, why not use the collar that is one of the best communication tools out there? Our goal is not to get the dog equipment free. Our goal is to eliminate pain and make your life better. So, it's up to you. And many dog trainers will shame people. Oh, the dog has a prong collar. You should have worked harder. You really didn't train it. That's the most insensitive, uncompassionate, biggest assholery remarks that a trainer can say. And it's really funny if you say that to one of my clients that's an actual brain surgeon. Like, sorry, I can't walk my dog without a prong collar. By the way, an hour ago, I was doing brain surgery. You want to come over into my arena and play? And I'm being serious. My goal is to make people's lives easier. And if it takes a prong collar on your dog when the leash is attached, so be it. But guess what? You still have to train your dog. Same with remote collars. Everybody thinks this is the standard cut and paste. You use a remote collar because you want to take shortcuts. I guarantee you, if I handed you a remote collar and you didn't understand dog training, you couldn't train your dog. It takes training still. We still use a leash. We still use food. We still use learning theory. We still teach yes. We still teach no. But the thing is, with a remote collar, I can override some of its natural instincts that can't be done any other way. So yes, huskies can be trained off leash. Beagles can be trained to recall. So we don't have to make excuses anymore. Where most people will say, well, I can, you know, the husky though can't recall or can't stop pulling because that's what it's bred to do. Well, I own German Shepherds. They were bred to do a lot of things, and I don't want them to do those things. Because why? People that I will get bit that I don't want to get bit, which is just about everybody. So getting off of tools is not my company or my personal philosophy. Helping humans and eliminating their pain and making their life easier is all I care about. If you want to take it farther, meaning if you want to get your dog off tools, you go right ahead. But if your dog is off leash in an unfenced in area and it's trained on a remote collar, especially for recall, and you decide not to have it on, what happens if? What happens if? So I have a will. I have a will, meaning if, I'm sorry, when I die, my affairs will be in order. Yes, there's large life insurance because I am the breadwinner of the family. At least I will know that my wife and my kids are taken care of, at least financially. There is a plan for my business, but I'm only going to be using that will one time. But that's going to be the important time. But I don't like to compare a shock collar to a will. What I'm saying is, your dog's trained on it, why not use it? Next.
Damn.
What?
Quite the analogy, Gellman.
Well, I mean, I think so many dog trainers are so quick to shame owners for using tools. And I'm saying that's one of the most insensitive things a trainer or another human being can ever do.
I had a remote on Wes this whole trip.
Yep, you should. Guess what? That's why he can come on this trip.
Yeah, with Kira being in heat, especially.
Yeah.
Him having balls.
Yes.
Melissa said, check out cool dog tricks here and posted the link.
Cool. Thanks, Melissa.
Judy, I went for a walk but forgot to bring Dickens with me. Oh, wait. No, he was there. I couldn't see him because he was behind me. Imagine that. Look at that, Judy.
Congratulations, Judy. Judy was in the photo of, she's been in many photos because she's been to many of my seminars.
She's like a groupie now.
She is.
Made a whole video about you today.
So, and then Joelle did a one-on-one. By the way, Judy, tell Marshall I said hello. Next.
Lynn, hi from the UK. No is such a powerful word. Thank you.
It sure is. Next.
Janine, so my male shepherd has recently started avoiding me and I'm his main handler. Mm-hmm. He does growl too and I get in his face and say no. Will he get over this?
Stop getting in your dog's face and saying no, you will get bit. So here's a great example of someone like yourself, who I love, who needs to understand how to properly apply a punisher to a dog. That is not how you do it. You say no, and there's a consequence. But I would cut down dramatically on the affection. To me, a dog that growls at its owner, especially its primary handler, is a relationship issue. Also, I don't know how old your dog is. So if it just hit the 9-month, between 18-month year, and all of a sudden that's happening, like that's where we're going with that dog. So a lot of people, what they do is they focus on the affection, the fun stuff, and they don't put down the rules, the structure, the consequences. Now, people are usually going to go, well, maybe it's sick and doesn't feel good. That's a possibility. But historically, it's behavioral. So don't get in its face and yell at it because the dog can snap at your face and bite you. Instead, learn how to apply a punisher. Next.
Melinda, 3-month-old Doberman still barking and whining in the crate. Was advised by you to stop bonking as it wasn't working because we may have been doing it wrong. He seems to easily get desensitized to any and all corrections we apply. Don't know what else to do. Please help.
I don't know your skill set. I would encourage you to do a Skype. Bonking works. you're probably doing it wrong, which doesn't make you a bad person, but there's historically no reason why a dog at 12 weeks old can't be told to be quiet and follow through. So what's happening is you're probably missing some opportunities, which most people do during the day with especially a young puppy. So you want to be training your dog to do a ton of things. So at that age, we do probably in a course of a day, we will do at least a minimum of 100 times, 100 repetitions of different commands, because that's how they eat. Probably more than 100, probably up to 150, three meals a day, 50 times each. So we would practice sit, down, place, kennel up, recall. We would probably reward eye contact. And then we would stop things. Usually at that age, you stop mouthing, jumping, barking, and whining. So it's possible you're doing it wrong. I don't know, I'm not there. So I advise you to stop doing it, because if you keep doing it and it doesn't work, that means you should stop doing it. But that doesn't mean it won't work. It just didn't work for you. Next.
Maria, hey, greetings from Poland. It's 3 a.m. here. Woke up specially for this Q&A. Oh my God.
Thank you so much.
Like fan of the year.
That's fantastic. I woke up at 2:38 this morning.
It's like a new record. You're going to stay up all night so that you can be like, I didn't sleep at all. I'm ready.
I would love to stay up 24 hours a day.
Never sleep.
I would love it. Next.
Yeah.
Okay. Are we dancing or
Lynn.
Asking questions over here?
Thanks for all your free information. It has helped with my German Shepherd.
Awesome. I'm proud of you.
Melinda, all corrections we apply. Don't know what else to do. Please help. I think I already read that.
You need help learning how to apply a correction. Guys, I have seen people apply corrections. Those aren't corrections. You need guidance. You need help. So, and this is just us talking. So invest in a Skype. Invest in Skype. Go to one of my seminars. So go to, oh, by the way, Cool Dog Tricks. Type in GIRL, G-I-R-L, as the coupon code. You'll get 25% off. As far as the seminars are concerned, they're life-changing. Read the comments. So don't listen to what the people say about them that have not gone. Go to our photo albums or go to the group photos and read underneath, and then listen to the testimonials of the people that actually go. Most testimonials from the seminar, people that are watching are crying watching them. This is a seminar like you've never seen before. Next.
Harmarsh, evening everyone.
Hello, how are you, Harmarsh?
Jillian, are there any states you know of that are looking to ban e-collars and prongs?
Talk a little bit louder.
I'm like screaming.
No, you're not. I mean, we're using this microphone. Okay. Any states? Oops. Sorry, guys. Sorry. So sorry. I'm in Canada.
Sorry.
Oops. Yep, oops is right. Okay, that fucking bonker
okay,
fucked it
better.
Up.
The lighting looks better, too.
Okay. Not yet. Hillsborough, Florida has tried to ban them, but pretty soon they're trying to ban them everywhere, as well as dog sports. So it started with greyhound racing. Pretty soon, just to let you guys know, agility will be illegal. Okay, so be careful what you sign, be careful what you donate money to, be careful how excitedly you dance on the banning of a certain thing because you don't like it, because the thing you do like is next. So greyhound racing was banned in Florida. Everybody celebrated that. But guess what's next? Fly ball, agility, dancing with dogs, dog performances, dock diving. It's all going to be banned. I want people to understand that PETA, if it was up to PETA, nobody would own a dog. All these people that are, all the money, the big money, we're talking about humongous amounts of money. So what happens is a politician that is able to enact a law in a county or in a state is given over $1 million to say, here, I will give you $1 million. Make sure this goes through. And they're like, do I break my moral code for $1 million? Yep, I think I will. Boom, next.
Double duckling. Hi guys, love your work. If dog's in place and starts loading when he sees another dog, Do I correct when I first see the signs or wait until a place is broken? Thanks.
You correct immediately and you correct high. Next.
Melinda, sorry, I should mention that it is demand barking and whining for food in the crate.
Okay. Chances are your dog is, first of all, who told you it was demand barking, number one? Who said that? Did you imagine that? So we don't know. Either way, if your dog just recently ate, and even if it was hungry, so what? It's not mealtime yet. You're not gonna die, all right? So teach the dog to be quiet. I don't care what it's for. Next. I shouldn't say that, sorry. If a dog has to go to the bathroom, I care, but chances are you're on a bathroom schedule as well. Next.
Jasmine, thank you guys for all of your advice. Your videos have been invaluable to me. I find myself coming back to them constantly.
Awesome, proud of you.
Zora, love your passion and work. I took my one-year-old Akita to the park. There was a small dog, kept being around her. She was out of mind. I didn't know what to do, and I kept turning it down.
She kept turn it down?
Kept her in a down.
Yeah, I would have removed that dog. I mean, if you were at a dog park where it's off leash, just sort of like, I mean, obviously your dog's off leash too, you could have just left. But if it was, I don't know the situation, but anytime there's a size difference between dogs and they're unknown dogs, I get out of there. Next.
Alicia, how do you get your dog to distinguish the difference between a potty break and a structured walk? Seems like every time I want to take them for a walk, they always think it's potty time no matter what.
Because that's the way you hold the leash, the way you keep the dog next to you. So when we're on a walk, my dogs don't think it's potty break until I come to a stop, go to a potty area, which I decide where it is, by the way, and I give them the 6 foot of leash and I say, go potty. Next.
Harmarsh, I used a prong on my boxer, American Sapphire Shear Terrier, and it worked immensely.
Yeah, prongs work on almost every single dog out there. So prongs are not a unique thing at all. So kudos to you for doing so. Next.
Bronwyn, my dog is so calm and kind, but when I walk him at night, I do notice he is a lot more alert. I do not mind this, as I do live in not the nicest neighborhood.
Okay, and I understand when I travel, Mac, who lives outside, does bark more. When Max, one of my other dogs, was alive, he also did the same whenever I traveled. So, you know, but that doesn't give your dog permission to lunge at people, though. Just keep that in mind. Next.
Britt, gorgeous kitty, love cats. I have two.
We have two cats at home as well, but that's Julie's cat.
What's her name again? Kiki. It's Kiki. Lainey, working my ass off every effing day with High Drive, 5-month-old. Look, she came. She knows recall. Watching all your videos, new and old. Without them, I'd quit. Heart you guys.
Awesome. Love you too. Thanks for all the hard work you're doing.
Carrie, my dog refuses to go number 2 on the leash. He will go 2 days with restricted freedom until he cannot hold it any longer. He will pee easily every time.
Yeah, I owned a dog like that too, and I actually let them off leash, or I let the leash drag. Next.
Harmarsh, mine was the same way, talking to Bronwyn.
Next.
Christian, hey guys, why is it that my GSC looks very sad when I put his muzzle on? He tucks his tail and breathes very heavily. He has leash reactivity, by the way.
Because he hates it. That's why. So, muzzle condition your dog to love it. It's all done with food and a clicker. Do we have a good video on that?
Yeah, we have a lot.
Do we? Yeah. It's all done with food and a clicker. Next.
Christian, and when will I know when he's ready to walk without the muzzle?
That's good. Well, that I can't answer because I don't know. The dog's not in front of me. I don't know your skill set. I don't know your dog. But, you know, we have clients who feel more comfortable with their dogs on muzzles. And when we're talking muzzle, we're talking about like a basket muzzle where the dog can drink water, breathe, pant, and eat through. And they can actually wear it for 24 hours at a time easily. So I don't know. I don't know. I don't know your skill set or your dog. Next.
Tyree, hi guys. So happy to catch the show live. You're both awesome.
Thank you so much. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it.
Bronwyn, I did have some men approach me once while walking at night, and he stood next to me giving them a low growl, and they backed off.
I have no problem with that whatsoever. Next.
Alicia, can a dog have a place in every room since they seem to follow me everywhere? I was thinking if I teach them place, then they can just have a place kind of everywhere.
So two things here. Yes, you can have a place in a room in every room, but stop the following around. Okay? So you have a place in every room because you want to be in the same room with your dog, not to solve the following go around. So actually what you want to start practicing, putting your dog in place and eventually leaving the room and correcting for non-compliance. But yes, you can have a place anywhere you want to. Next.
Deanna, regarding the 14-week-old pup, is a bit of pop or pressure too much to get him to walk with you if he's resistant?
No.
You want to do the right thing, but not too much.
No, it's not. A little bit of a pop is fine. Next.
Jillian, I'd like to use daycare 2 days a week. 2-year-old has been in daycare for some time, and 4-month-old is new to it. How do I find a daycare that aligns with our training methods?
Good luck. So, you probably won't. I don't know where you're located. Come to ours in Providence. So, you might not, and, you know, I don't know. You'd find a trainer that offers, the trains similar that offers structured daycare. Most daycares are not structured. Most daycares are the Wild West, and if that's the way they want to run their business model, that's fine. To me, I personally wouldn't do that, though. But that's just me. Many people do it, and many dogs are fine with it. Next.
Janine, I meant to donate $10. LOL. Sorry, I'm challenged. Oh, my God.
Don't worry about it. Yeah, I think it just said $1.99. So, but don't worry about it. It's fine. I don't care.
Perry, if the bonker doesn't stop the leash reactivity toward other dogs, is the remote collar the next step in punishment? He is a high-drive male coonhound.
You might have bonked wrong. I've used the bonker on some intense high-drive dogs. But the remote collar is not like the last choice. The remote collar is a fantastic training tool for everything, for both on-leash and off-leash obedience. So, but also there is a skill set, guys. There is a skill set. I can't tell you how many people say clicker training doesn't work. But I would say, yes, it does. You just don't know what you're doing. And what were you trying to do? What were you trying to teach the dog to do? Because that's what clickers do. It's a marker after the dog did it right. And that's followed up then with a reward. So it all depends on what you're trying to do. I mean, that's the important thing. So there is a skill set. So for people to say that shock collars don't work, it's like, what are you trying to stop? Or what are you trying to train? Yes, they do. But there still is a skill set. So it boils down to having the right skills. Next.
Alicia, love you guys. Can't wait for the replay. Gotta go. Thanks so much for your care and compassion.
Awesome. Thank you so much for caring as well.
Maria, adopted 3-year-old Weimaraner with separation anxiety. Barking collar works, but 4 out of 7 hours of absence, she walks from part A to part B or stands still after finally lays down. How do I make her calm when I leave?
Why isn't she? How old is the dog?
3 years old.
So put her in a crate. Crate your dog. Just crate the dog. It's okay to crate the dog. It's like for 7 hours? Well, you're not home for 7 hours, so yeah. Next.
Pedro, sometimes I get laughed at a lot when training at the dog park because I don't speak very good English. But it's okay. I don't understand what you say sometimes in your videos, but your body language helps me.
So for anybody that laughs at you because of your language or if you had a speech impediment or your appearance, that's on them. That's on them, not you. So for somebody to laugh at you because of your lack of English skills or your whatever, that's on them. So those are called what we call in English, not nice people. And in every language, this translates really well, fucking assholes, right? So you want to, right? That's the universal language, fucking assholes. So anybody that does that, that's who they are. Those aren't nice people. So, and what they are is they're bullies. So don't worry about it. Next.
$14.99 top chat from Janine. No question.
Thank you, Janine. Love
Thanks,
you.
Thanks, Janine. Pedro says, keep doing good videos.
I'm trying to. Thank God I've got Joelle and her video team to help edit them too and put them together and make me look good. Next.
Bronwyn. Hi, J&J. It's been a while since I caught a live. It's super weird seeing my name pop up when it's not me. Got an update from a friend today whose dog I trained. She's able to take her to work now. So proud.
What a great feeling. Kudos to you, Bronwyn.
Asia.
So which Bronwyn is that? Is that Bronwyn
that Bronwyn is our going to be our intern.
Okay.
The other Bronwyn is the other Bronwyn from Canada.
Who's not going to be the intern. Unless you wanted to intern with us. So
we'll take all the Bronwyns from Canada.
Bronwyns from Canada. So we're looking forward to you interning with us, Bronwyn. Next.
Asia, I have 4 dogs in the house, 2 of mine, 2 of my brothers. I'm wondering how I can train them at home.
So one at a time. So you put 3 in a crate, take one out, train it, and then rotate them. And then eventually they can all be in place, and then you can work them one at a time as well. But hopefully, if 2 of them are your brothers and your brother lives there, he will either participate or pay you. Next.
Jamie. Some comedy relief. Wanted to say I'm still training in Mandarin Chinese, so most people can't just bark out commands to my dog unless I go to China, I guess.
Or if you talk to or if you talk to Angelo, because
he knows Chinese.
Because Angelo, my son, knows Chinese.
That's great. Training Mandarin, like, it must be so hard.
Yeah, that's good. Good.
That's great. $10 from Crystal. I want to bring my husband to a seminar so he understands how to handle his dog, but he doesn't like you. I told him to suck it up, Buttercup. It's the seminar or the dog goes.
So, you know, what I would say is this, is, first of all, I don't give a shit if people like me or not. But I would ask him, honey, why?
Yeah,
why? I'm not, and I don't want him to like me. He doesn't have to like me. If he's rude at my seminar, I'll kick him out. But he doesn't have to like me. But if he wants to be the token dude that's like this all day with a scowl on his face at the seminar, that's fine. But what I always say to people is, why don't you like me? What is it? So a good thing is, it's so funny because we just put up a post from Pat, who found me through a hater. And we just had somebody come in. We get a lot of business from haters. And they're like, oh, they, you know, they, you know, Gellman's an asshole, that we don't like Jeff. And you know what people ask? Why? Why? Did you hear this? Have you met him? Have you sat down with dinner with him? Have we ever had a conversation together? Or you're just hearing things? Or you think that when I'm outrageous and crazy on my show, that's the real me? So what happens is, unfortunately, with an attitude like that, not that me and your husband are going to be good friends, but going into any sort of situation with preconceived notion, you might be missing out on some of the best stuff of your life. And that doesn't just mean humans, it means opportunities in life. It means neighborhoods, it means meeting a neighbor. It means traveling to a country. It means, but also it means, yeah, a partner. So, you know, if he doesn't want to go, don't drag him. Okay? Don't drag him. Bring your boyfriend instead. Next.
So casual.
Well, what's so funny about
that? Bring your boyfriend instead.
Yeah, just bring your boyfriend. Next.
Yeah. Everyone's got one of those in their back pocket. Yep. Maria. Thanks to your YouTube videos and hard work, separation anxiety dog learned about being calm on place.
Awesome.
But every time she loses me from sight, breaks the command, trying to check on me, how to get rid.
So put the dog on a tie back. A tie back is a leash attached to something that doesn't move. Remote collar on the dog. Teach the dog that when it leaves a known command, make sure that dog knows place very well. You can correct a dog for non-compliance of a known command, whatever the distraction is. If you are leaving the room is the distraction and the dog follows, you can correct the dog for doing that. Okay? And this also applies to children. So my children, our children, have always been really good about, hey, Angelo, go in the room and play. And we'll see him 3 to 4 hours later. He's not one of these kids that's like, mommy, 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 daddy, daddy, daddy. It's like he knows how to play well. He's 6, so he knows how to play with himself too now. So he knows how to play by himself. Next.
I don't think so. He's too innocent.
No, young, they, you know, in the womb, children touch their private parts.
Yeah, well, that's just like, there's no room in there.
So they're masturbating because of space limitation?
I wouldn't call it masturbation.
Okay. So when you're in the sun tanning booth, are you masturbating? It's a tight spot.
Okay.
Next.
Teresa, every dog having the same public access training as service dogs would solve so many issues.
Yeah. And it's not that difficult to do. It really isn't that difficult to do at all. Next.
Megan, dog is struggling with epilepsy. Frustrated because after each seizure, we take steps back. He's not as sharp on meds. Don't want to make excuses. Just not himself. And I'm not sure I should be pushing him.
Yeah, that's, you know, I don't have a, okay. Yes, we've worked with dogs with epilepsy. I have not owned one. So I don't know your struggle. That's a struggle. I've got a huge amount of empathy for it, but that's a struggle that I don't have firsthand knowledge. So I'm limited to the advice I can give you, because every time I give advice, it's based on hundreds, if not thousands, of dogs worked with the exact same problem. Next.
One big weirdo. How do you train the out command?
I've got a free video on that. We do it with a remote collar. You say the word out, and then you hit a remote collar at a level that would make the dog want to either spit out the ball, move away from the food bowl, back away from something. Next.
Melissa, if you have a 2.5-month-old puppy that resource guards, how do you deal with that? Is he too young for the prong collar?
I would use a bonker. So if I had a 10-week-old puppy that was resource guarding, okay, that dog would get no and a bonk instantly. Instantly. And for people out there to say, oh, just like take a high value treat and throw it on the side. So imagine this. There's the food bowl and your dog is guarding it. If people don't know what resource guarding is, it means the guarding of something. So this is what is common. This is the advice that is given by certified dog trainers. I say certified because everyone seems to think that makes them better, but it doesn't at all. It just makes them have a better memory to take a fucking test. Okay? So what happens is, it doesn't mean they have more experience, and it definitely doesn't mean they know how to fix problems, because most dog trainers don't know how to fix things. So and then veterinary behaviorist sounds really sophisticated, but all that does is mean they can charge you $500 to $800, give you a stack of paper, which is very hard to read because it's really big words. So in dog training, usually anything more than 2 syllables is not necessary, okay? So what they'll tell you to do often is this. The dog is guarding a food bowl. What you do is you take something of higher value and you exchange it. Or you throw it to the side so the dog then goes for that so you can take the food bowl. Let me make this really, really clear. That's how you would train an aggressive dog. Up to you. So what I would do is no bonk. The dog goes, holy shit, that sucked. Yes, it did. Don't ever growl at me again. These are simple concepts. Next.
Maria, while leading to place with the leash, dog has no problem, but being without it after giving her distance place command, she just walks in the right direction and stops looking at me. How do you make dogs so motivated to go to place, like recently Fenton? My Weimaraner walking towards place looks like being given the worst punishment.
Okay, well, first of all, they all don't look like Fenton does, okay? But also, Fenton has probably done it 500 times, and I don't know how many times you've done it, and I don't know your skill set. It does take time. We have many dogs that no matter what we do, look miserable going to place. And that doesn't mean we're doing it wrong. They're just not thrilled about it. And it's not like they feel like they're being punished. Well, make it more fun. Some dogs just don't care.
No.
Next.
Shona, I ordered prong collars and used for the first time today. Worked like a charm.
Awesome.
Next. Maria, I tried to cut off affection with a separation anxiety dog, but I observed more problems with disobedience and breaking commands while doing it. You think it makes sense?
It has nothing to do with cutting off affection. It's not connected. The reason why you... Is it raining outside?
No, I think it's a fan of some sort.
The reason why you're getting more things is because it's called whack-a-mole. Okay? It's called whack-a-mole. So what happens is you might be just recognizing more things, or you were giving affection to stop an unwanted behavior, and now you're not giving affection, so the unwanted behaviors are more prevalent. But cutting down on affection is not most likely creating more problems. Next.
Lay dog. Bonker. I want to say they work, but my dog still barks, lunges, and acts up when he sees another dog. So annoying and scary at times. It's not capturing his attention. I feel he blacks out.
Okay.
When we are on a walk, lunging at the door, it's working.
Okay. Outside is a different picture. Make sure you're saying no and then you're bonking. Okay. Once the dog is in full arousal and the outside is different than the inside, a lot of times it is contextual. Sometimes it also is universal. And for your dog, you just have to find another punisher for outside. What I would do is I would start the walk with a pre-walk bonk. Next.
FOMO. Evening. Pit Mix is obsessing over and wanting to chase a new cat in the house. She's e-collar trained, and I've gotten her to the point of avoidance, but only for short periods. Where do I go from here?
You're not correcting high enough if you really want to get avoidance. Next.
Janine, thank you. My male GSD is 19 months. We'll be in Florida seminar ASAP. I will watch all your Punisher videos.
Awesome. Next.
Melissa posted the links to your seminar. Britt, last night there were guys using a punching bag and my dog freaked out, so I made her stay, but she wanted to bolt. Is there anything that I could have done to make it easy?
Yeah, I would have probably utilized a little bit of space and done some counter conditioning protocols. Next.
Tyree, Florida resident, Greyhound racing was banned with very little time before it went into effect, but there was no plan or safety net, which equals massive flood of homeless dogs, horrible result for hundreds of dogs.
Yep, it's funny because a lot of that hardcore Greyhound people think it was the most wonderful thing in the world. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure there's truth to both sides of it, but all I know is this. If you are, okay, it is in a Greyhound racing owner. First of all, Greyhounds in the racing industry are a commodity. We have to understand that. Most work dogs are a commodity. We have to understand that. But to say that Greyhounds are treated more poorly than your average family dog who ends up in a shelter, I think we need to have a reality check. It's sort of like the pit bull people saying that they're the greatest dog ever. No, they're not. Like the nanny dog. It's like, I work with pitties and I love the breed, but the last thing I'd ever want them to do is to be around my kids. And I can say that for every breed of dog. So what happens is, if someone feels that a dog is being harmed, there is proper channels in place. But for banning something, it might eliminate it, but they're not realizing what the shrapnel effect is, which is what this person said. Next.
Melinda, thank you for your compassion, Jeff. We may just have to save our pennies for Skype.
To do that. What I would do is I would stop going out for coffee, pack your own meals, take all that crap you have lying around your house. Literally empty out 75% of your closet and flip it on Facebook Marketplace. And you'll not only be able to pay for a Skype, you'll probably be able to take a vacation. Next.
Maria, Prong Collar works on walks. Finally, my dog is healing, but I still don't like its place too much in front. How to place dog behind my leg to keep this position?
You sound like what Judy was struggling with, okay?
Are you related to Judy?
So why don't you answer that question?
Utilize spatial pressure. So layer it with, let's see, what tools are you using so I can help you out? Prong. So do a lot of left-handed turns into your dog and pop them behind you as you're turning left. They'll start to eventually yield to your space and stay behind your knee.
You can also do
use your body.
You can also use a 180. You can also use a heel tap to the chest.
Yep.
Next.
Britt, my German Shepherd saw a skateboard and did not run and stayed for the first time without bolting. Huge.
Awesome. Huge. Congratulations for all the hard work you're doing. Next.
Jillian, what is the purpose of using the clicker? Doing food luring and saying good or yes for desired behaviors? Is this enough?
If it's working for you, yes. But luring and rewarding are two different things. So just for clarification, the purpose of a clicker is it is a marker. Now it could be a positive or a negative marker, which people think it's always a positive, but I can make a negative marker. I can make the word no a positive marker.
Can we do a tip of the day on this tomorrow?
Sure. Next.
Shannon, hello J&J. We met back in June at Michelle's facility. The prong has changed everything for us. One of them, though, sniffs my husband's knee during walks. Is that something that needs correcting?
It all depends on if your husband likes it or not. Next.
Hater Slayer, I have a decent skill set here. 7-month-old husky pity mix doing awesome in training to run next to me using e-collar. Thanks for the awesome content.
Awesome. Proud of you. And what a joy that is. Be super careful. The running is probably going to be okay. Be careful on the jumping over things because the bone structure is not fully formed, but that's out of my skill set. Jumping off of things. But running, people are like, don't run too far with your dog. It's like, if your dog was in the backyard running around, I assure you, chances are Hater Slayer is not running as fast as a dog actually probably would run in the backyard free. So, next.
Kara, what is an average per hour pay for a trainer at your facility?
That's not something I'm going to disclose, but I do spend about $300,000 a year on payroll. So if you own a business and you want to do a business consult, I'll be more than happy to let you know. But we pay above industry average. And if you want to have a private conversation, I also won't tell you how much money I make a year. So, you know, that's one of those questions that you just don't ask. Next. Well, you could. I just won't give you an answer. Next.
Taylor, hey, J&J. Can't wait to see you guys in Seattle. I have a Belgian Malinois puppy, 5 months old, that I think is ready for e-collar intro. Too soon? What age do you start your puppies on e-collar?
14 weeks old. Next.
Carrie, my dog is so much easier to bathe with a prong collar on. He doesn't push back against me or resist pressure as much, making my back not hurt afterwards. I no longer dread doggy bath time.
Look at that. Awesome. I'm glad that it's probably better for both of you. Good job. Next.
That's it right now.
Good. And thank you, Ben, for bathing all of our dogs.
Yeah.
Ben is one of our newest employees, and he's killing it. He's a driven guy. You know, when did he bathe him? Tuesday. Some Monday, some Tuesday, yeah. Right before we left. And it's the RV smells like bathed dogs.
Clean dogs, yeah.
They haven't gone in the water.
Yeah.
They haven't rolled around in anything yet. So,
yet.
So it's good. So traveling with 5 dogs, you know, is going to definitely be, so far it's been good, man. We've been rocking it. Mm-hmm. But next.
Rebecca, when do tools become less prominent? Going for the long game approach, does my shepherd need a prong for life?
So Rebecca already asked. Someone asked that question. We already gave an answer. Next.
Jordan, do you recommend a prong collar for my 3.5-month-old miniature Australian shepherd that's 15 pounds? If so, what size? He either wants to pull me forward on walks or lays and resists walking.
Yes, I would do a 2.25 millimeter Herm Springer collar. We have them on our website. You don't have to get them from us. Get them on Amazon. Excuse me, but just to let everybody know, there's a bunch of knockoff Herm Springer collars, and they do make a difference. Next.
That's it.
Okay. So you can go to jeffgellmanseminars.com, jeffgellmanseminars.com. We are actually heading down to Charlotte this weekend. It's really hot outside. We've had actually made some...
Is it raining? Or is that a fan?
I think that's that fan.
It's not raining out, right? Okay.
Yeah. So we actually had to make some new arrangements. So... From a barn, an open barn, we've gone to now a 40x30 tent with those air conditioners that you might see at a wedding or something. Mm-hmm. We rented a generator. We've got external air conditioners that are being piped in when we have a tent, all for this seminar. So it's the cost of a small wedding now
anybody you want to get married to?
To put this on. So we have more audit tickets available because all of a sudden this seminar is costing me $4,000 more than I thought. So
Should get married at the seminar. Aren't you like able to do that stuff?
Am I able to marry somebody?
Yeah.
It wouldn't be legal, but sure, I'll marry somebody.
I thought you had like that thing. Maybe not.
No, Sean and Marta wanted to. So Sean and Marta,
what do they call it? Ordained or something?
An ordained minister. They want me to actually officiate their wedding.
I want you to marry Josh and I too.
It's like
Josh gonna marry everyone.
It's like
great.
I was married in Vegas. I mean, Vegas is a good place to do it. So
it's great. Yeah. So yeah, it's gonna be a good time.
Yeah. What else is happening? So RV life is good. We want to get an oil change on the road and then also get it washed.
Might have to take Wes to the vet.
What's that?
Might have to take Wes to the vet for his ear. I don't know.
Julie, do you have your vet? Is your vet local?
Yeah.
I think we might have to go to the vet tomorrow. Yeah, so we'll get that information. So So we just put on Julie's account. But it's been good. So actually right after the show, it's what, 10:10 right now. I still have to feed my dogs.
I need to shower.
So you need to shower. I have to feed my dogs. We'll probably leave the generator running on. I might want to plug in, hon. I might not. I'm probably going to run the generator all night long, so I don't need to plug in anyway. Yeah. So just because it's all those dogs and with Kira and Heat, and then there's all the dogs. It's like it generates a lot of, you know, the dog area generates a lot of heat. What's that, hon?
There's room in the kennel.
No, that's fine. No, they're fine in their kennels. Yeah, it's a good routine we have. It's really, really good. So I'm looking forward to it. We're gonna do some good cooking too. Mm-hmm. We picked up steak, chicken, fish. So we've got salmon, chicken breast, and we've got some steaks.
Turkey.
And then we've got some ground turkey, shrimp. Mm-hmm. We got some shrimp. Then we've got tons of salad stuff.
Yeah.
What's that fruit that we're gonna give it a shot?
Guava.
I'm sure I've had guava before at restaurants, but I never bought it at a store. So I've got some guava. Then we've got bananas and grapes.
Everything. Some oatmeal.
That oatmeal.
We got everything.
Yeah, a lot of, you know, we eat healthy on the road. We really, really do. Yep. So this is really great. We'll probably go out twice on the road. To our host, we'll take Laura out, I'm sure, and her husband out for dinner one night. And but we love it. We you know, you just stick to your schedule, guys. Routine. People are like, God, you work so hard. It's like, I'm working so hard because I'm trying to change the world. You know, right now, if you want to start your own business, now is the time to do it, because there's more money out there than there ever has been before. But you better start working hard now. So for all the people right now who are doing well but not working hard, I want you to know in a couple of years, when the economy gets possibly a little bit challenging, a lot of people are going to struggle. So it's the ones that are working hard that are going to last. Because right now there's a lot of easy money out there. But pretty soon, you're going to see a lot of that dry up eventually. The economy is doing extremely well right now, but things go in cycles. So what you do is you start, I want everyone right now to start saving and accruing lots of money, because what happens is when things go bad, that's when you buy things.
Yeah.
That's when you buy things. So like Joelle's looking at a house right now. We might stop at that house on the way back. It's a nice looking house in the Catskills. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, you know, she's smart. She's living at the center for free and buying a house. And it won't be in an HOA because that's just stupid. any more questions?
Shannon says, you guys are sexy. Keep up the great work.
Oh, well, thank you.
Thanks.
Very much. Not together because we're not a couple. If we actually work together, thank you. But thank you so much. I'll take sexy any day. I'm 53 years old. And you can call me
Jeff Sexy Gellman.
You can call me anything, man. I'll take sexy. Dudes, go ahead. You can call me sexy. I don't give a shit. Grandma, call me sexy. I really don't care. Next. Okay.
Cynthia, thank you for all you do.
You're welcome. Cynthia, thank you for being a fan. Thank you for being a follower. Guys, thank you for all the thumbs up. No one's giving, where's that token thumbs down? Somebody must hate me.
It's going to come in like three.
Where's that woman whose husband hates me? Tell him to join my show and fucking give me a thumbs down, please, okay? If you're not part of our family, hit solid canine training and then hit the notification.
Maria, is it possible to cure a dog from separation anxiety and stop using bark collar one day?
Well, cure. Well, first of all, yes, it is. But second of all, let's say you had to leave the bark collar on every time you left the house. And, right? Mm-hmm. What's the problem? Charge it when you're home, put it on when you're not home. That's sort of like, so I was struggling with high blood pressure, 225 over 127.
Oh my God.
Yep, they thought I was actually gonna have a seizure. They rushed me into the hospital.
227?
No, 127, 225 over 127. So I just went back to my heart doctor. My blood pressure is now 122 over 72, which for me is really good. And I said, cool, so I can stop all these meds that I'm on. I'm on three medications. I was on four, but I dropped one. He goes, no, Jeff, because there's something called hereditary as well. So I eat well, I exercise, I've got my work-life balance is terrible, but I'm just love what I do. I mean, it could be worse. I could be one of these dudes that comes home and just plays video games all day. but if I was making money at it, I won't knock you. I won't knock you. But if it causes a divorce, you know, guys, just to let you know, I got nothing against gamers. In fact, I think gamers are really cool. But if you're in a relationship and you're coming home from work and you've got children and a spouse and you're playing video games and you're a grown-ass fucking man, especially, like, it's time to rethink your priorities, okay? Now, just think about that next. And by the way, I have nothing against gamers, okay? Nothing. Because there are people, the 12 wealthiest people on YouTube are gamers. I've got nothing against gamers. I'm talking about, like, ignoring some of your responsibilities in life. Next.
Jillian, just saw the video on your most severe separation anxiety case. Pity that Joelle stayed up with all night the first night. How did that all end up playing out?
The first two nights, after 1 week, that dog was in a wire crate with no tools on, doing fine. And we patterned that over 5 weeks, and it's doing fine. It was just back for boarding.
Doing fine.
And it's doing fine. At home, I don't know. And if we knew, we would keep it private, not because it's not going well, but we document the work when the dog is with us. But that's it.
Yeah.
That's it. That doesn't mean we're trying to hide anything. It means, like, there's also privacy issues. And a lot of people also don't want to just, you know, it takes a lot of courage for a lot of folks to share their stuff. Next.
Norm says, thanks, Jeff and Joelle.
You're welcome.
Sherry, been super busy, so I've missed you guys for a couple of weeks. Much love from Sherry and Marley in San Fran.
Oh, thank you. Hey, we're going to be in Petaluma soon. Can't wait. In fact, I got to book that Airbnb.
Yeah.
I don't know. Should we look for another one?
I don't know.
I really like that one a lot. We just stayed in a really nice one in Fargo. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's really nice. Yeah, next.
Jesse, getting my puppy on Friday. He'll be around 10 weeks old. Any tips?
Yeah, millions of tips. Too many for this podcast, I'll tell you that much. So training starts the minute you get the dog. So structure, massive amounts of structure, massive amounts of routine, plenty of crate time, do all food training. Be careful about carrying the dog around. It's not a teddy bear. It's gonna grow. You're not raising a puppy, you're raising a dog. Okay? So, Angelo, I'm raising a man. I'm not raising a six-year-old. I'm raising a man. So, what do I want him to be like when he is a man? And that is the moral compass that I'm giving him now, the information I'm giving him now, the conversations I have with him now. Because he is going to be a man, and he's going to be a very loving, compassionate, confident, kind, gentle man. So that starts now. That starts now. Next.
Harmarsh, I really enjoy your videos. This is the first live stream I've caught. I'm on 10 different meds for my heart.
So I never finished that. Well, and keep taking them, I would imagine. I'm not a doctor. But so I asked my heart doctor, I said, so can I get off these meds now? He's like, no, Jeff, you stay on the meds. So if those three meds plus changes I've made in my diet and my health routine have literally saved my life, well then, so be it. Next.
That was a big, long detour to answer a question.
Yeah.
New Zealand Kiwi, really enjoying following along your guys' RV road trip. As always, thank you for the great content and help you guys provide us to us all.
My pleasure. And I'll be in Auckland in July of 2020. Woo-hoo. So that's obviously, you know, for people that are not, don't know New Zealand, it's the northern tip. And I'm really looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to going to the hot springs as well. Next.
Adriana, hey guys, your videos had helped me a lot. Me and my dog are still working on his behavior around other dogs and people. Since he is scared easily, he will still jump back sometimes, but I did see some improvement in our training. Love you guys.
So Adriana, kudos to you for all the hard work. And just to let you know, your dog backing up is okay. I'd rather have your dog back up when it's uneasy than lunge forward. Okay? Next.
That's it.
That's all we got? Okay. So, after this, we have the Las Vegas seminar. Guys, come to Vegas.
I want to come to Vegas.
Las Vegas. Come to Vegas.
Fly Julie out?
No, we already are flying. We're already flying somebody out. So we're flying another camera person out. Yeah, we're flying another camera person out. So, yeah. So Las Vegas is going to be fun. Not only is it at the Flamingo Hotel, who's putting it on. They're my sponsor. They're not putting it on. Well, I guess they are. We're doing the full Vegas experience, getting picked up at the airport in a limo by them. They're bringing us to the seminar. We're doing a Q&A. We're doing a live Q&A, live with a studio audience there. Then we're doing a Q&A on Saturday night. But go to jeffgellmanseminars.com and look at the Las Vegas link, and you'll see all the things we're doing. We're also doing a Monday. You can do one-on-ones. And also for my New Zealand folks, I got to give my host a call. I might do a 3-hour business one, a little mini seminar for people that own businesses in New Zealand to help them build their businesses, because I really want to help as many people as possible. Any plans to come to Virginia? I'm going to be in South Carolina. Did I publish that yet, Julie?
I don't think so.
Frederick, did I
pump? No,
you said you're going to be in South Carolina. What does that have to do with anything?
Well, it's driving distance from Virginia. So people that are in Virginia, you can either come to my Ohio one or my Frederick one. So that's what I meant by that. Or you can come to the one in New Jersey, in Manitowoc, New Jersey. But there's nothing in Virginia yet. But my 2020 schedule is not done. But if you're in Virginia, you are very drivable to about 3 that are already on the books. Next.
Any plans to come to Denver, Colorado?
I'm trying to put, okay, so guys, I'm trying to put Colorado and Arizona on the 2020 schedule as soon as I find a location. Next.
Maria, I do lots of structure at home and walks. Is it right to give the dog 1 hour a day to run on a 15-meter leash or loose with the other dogs? I feel Weimaraner needs it, but I don't want free roam to destroy my hard work.
Well, free roaming should be outside. Are you talking about outside or inside?
Sounds like outside.
Yeah, outside is fine. Yeah, I run my dogs all the time outside. Yeah, next.
Will you be in Ohio?
Yes. Guys, Jeff. GellmanSeminars.com. So you can go to the Canton, Ohio seminar, or you can go to the Elkhart, Indiana seminar. Both are very close to you. So, yes, next.
D. Pascal, my pit bull is a separation anxiety girl. She's a rescue.
Okay, so.
Terrible on the leash and pees everywhere.
Okay, so all dogs are rescue dogs. That has nothing to do with it whatsoever. Rescue is not a breed. So it's to stop that whole, you know, all my dogs are rescue dogs, but I don't call them rescue dogs. I call them dogs. So rescue is not a breed. They're called a dog. Most dogs out there owned by people are rescues. So you don't need to say rescue. As far as separation anxiety, I've got tons of information on my YouTube channel on how to stop separation anxiety. Historically, the first night they're with us, it goes away, because we have the information, but we share that information free and generously through our YouTube channels. Next.
New Zealand Kiwi, awesome, awesome, awesome. Help with growing businesses will be a bonus.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna see if I do it. And the problem is on Mondays, we're doing private one-on-ones. I mean, you can always book a one-on-one to help grow your business. You can always do that as well. So when you book a one-on-one, it's about anything you want. So many people have booked like 2-hour one-on-ones to talk about business. But I might do a 3-hour one. I think we talk about Sunday night, 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. We just have to figure out a price on that. And then we might limit it to like 10 people or something like that. I mean, we'll probably include dinner or something.
Yeah.
Yep. Next.
D. Pascal, or Cynthia says thank you. D. Pascal says, I got her a pinch collar. It helps a little. I had to get her a diaper due to the peeing. She doesn't pee in the diaper, and it seems to calm her. What else can I do?
Like I said, what I want you to do is go to my YouTube channel, type in separation anxiety. There's a video to watch. Start with that video. The biggest thing is massive amounts of structure. Cut down on affection. Do obedience training. Correct for whining and crying and barking in the crates. Don't let the dog follow you around. Next.
Rebecca, thank you. Quality response to my question. Appreciate it.
You're welcome, Rebecca.
Melinda, excited for Danica's story on her seminar experience. When and where can we expect to see it?
So Danica, that's one of the videos that Joelle is editing. Where Joelle works about 80 hours a week. In fact, today while she was, and so Joelle gets car sick. And today in the car, she edited three videos, knowing that looking at that screen makes it worse. So you're doing it or are we having someone else do it?
I'm doing it.
You're doing it. So we're doing our best to get to it. I wish I had even more people on my team because we have so much content. We just have so much content out there. Her story is wonderful. So I'm not quite sure when. That's why when people like request, can you make a special video on? I'm like, no, we can't. It's like, we have so much stuff that we're working on. It's hard for us to keep up. But that is, I think, that's something that is definitely a priority mm-hmm. for Joelle. But also Joelle has to just also like live life. Like, and she pursues, most of her life right now is solid canine training. So right now she's devoting most of her waking hours to my company. And it's obviously goes appreciated and most of it privately appreciated, but publicly, you know, I'm not going to praise her constantly in public in front of everybody. So next.
Adriana, I have questions that I was hoping me and my dog can run together maybe in the future. He is a lab blue heeler, so he has energy. How should he be to be running at my side? He's 6 months old now.
How old? I mean, unless you're an Olympic athlete, and even then, that would probably still be a trot for your dog. Your dog most likely runs around your backyard 3 to 4 times faster than you run. So there's probably no reason why you can't. But running on hard pavement, you know, that's sort of like a vet question to ask as far as bone structure. Next.
D. Pascal says, will do. Thank you very much. Yep. Greg, will you guys ever be in the Washington, D.C. area?
So, again, the one we do in Frederick is, which if it isn't up, because we got confirmed dates on that.
I don't think it's up. No, we confirm.
Yeah, we have the second dates, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
It's only a half hour from D.C.
It's a half hour. Yeah, it's close. So, you're going to look for the Frederick one next.
Oh, Melinda, dang, Joelle is such a boss.
She is a boss. She's probably the hardest working person that I've met besides myself. She's the 25-year-old female version of me, and she's going lots and lots of places, and I'm hoping it'll be with this company. So super proud of her. Anyway, guys, it's time for us to go. It's been 90 minutes. We are madly in love with you. I'm honored and blessed, and thank you guys all. Sorry we had to move it an hour later. Thank you for doing it when I know you'd rather be sleeping right about now. Actually, you'd probably rather go in the shower and then go to sleep.
I literally am just like, I can't fucking wait to take a shower.
Yes. So
it's all I'm thinking about.
So love you guys. Take care. Bye-bye.